to you, the parents, families, and friends of the 2002 graduating class of Douglas Anderson School of the Arts. Parents, you sit ready to witness one of the most important occasions in your child's life, high school graduation. I know how proud you must be, and I congratulate you. Tonight, we are here to celebrate and remind ourselves of the importance of each of these young people and how valuable they are to all of us. How appropriate that our graduation takes place in a performing arts theater instead of a gymnasium or a huge coliseum. We are assembled tonight in the lovely Moran Theater. The class will be led in by the senior class president, followed by the valedictorian and the salutatorian. The senior class president will step aside and watch as her class goes by. All of these are part of our tradition. Then she will receive her medallion from me. In doing so, she will represent all her classmates receiving the medallion, a Douglas Anderson tradition. The valedictorian and the salutatorian are the first to receive their diplomas, followed by all students who are platform guests. Please note, at this point, would all of you please turn off your cell phones and all electronic gadgets? Thank you. Please note, as part of the Douglas Anderson tradition, the valedictorian and salutatorian will lead the graduates out of the theater, and the senior class president will be the last to leave. Another proud tradition at Douglas Anderson has been that our commencement exercise is a very formal, dignified program, one that we feel honors these young students of art. On that note, I would like to request from you that you also participate formally in this ceremony. During the presentation of diplomas, your role and ours is to honor the graduates with this respectful silence as each name is called. More importantly, the senior class is requesting that upon the announcing of each student's name, we allow that graduate a special moment of having his or her name sound through the silence in this beautiful theater. And during that brief period, each of us will share together through our silence the respect that each graduate deserves. This graduation is the last artistic ceremony that your graduates will participate in as Douglas Anderson School of the Arts students. As many of you know, our graduations are not like others. They traditionally, as I said, are elegant, artistic, and represent culturally what our students have learned. Tonight belongs to the students, not the audience. Please help us ensure that the policemen throughout the theater do not have to remove anyone for disrupting this ceremony. After all graduates' names have been called, we will ask the audience in unison give to the celebrated occasion an extended period of resounding applause and cheers for all our graduates and their varied accomplishments. I invite you now to unite with our graduates, our faculty, and all the guests present here tonight. Together, we present an elegant, artistic style graduation 2002. Would you please stand?
Would you please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
is in memory of our dear friend and classmate, Derek Dixon. Although he is not here with us on stage, he will forever be in our hearts and our minds. And at this time, if you would please bow your head in prayer with me. Dear Heavenly Father, as I speak in this place, surrounded by my fellow graduates, teachers, family, friends, and guests, I ask your blessings on all of us as we begin the new chapter in our lives. I would like to thank you for all that I am and all that I have for making this amazing day. The people you have blessed us with have helped us in so many ways to make this day come true, and we thank you. Please help us to open our eyes to the world we are about to enter and to guide our footsteps. But most of all, please let us never forget all that has molded us into what we are today, and the people who have touched our lives and hearts. And now, those who choose, would you please join me in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Parents, guardians, family, and friends, on behalf of the senior class, it is my honor to welcome you to the 2002 commencement ceremony. Thank you for joining us on this special occasion.
It is now my pleasure to introduce our platform guest. Audience, please hold your applause until they have all been introduced. And guest, as I call your name, please remain standing until all have been introduced. First of all, we have Jackie Cornelius, principal. Katie Etmeyer, senior class president. McGlade Holloway, assistant superintendent for facilities, Duval County School Board. Deborah Long Parker, language arts teacher and graduation reader. Clay Brinson, assistant principal, student services. Deborah Knorr, school advisory chair. Gay Mason, PTSA president and parent. Kathy Mortensen, guidance counselor. Jimmy Johnson, Duval County School Board chairman and representative of District 5. Catherine Walton, valedictorian. Mark O'Connor, teacher of the year. Brenda White, guidance counselor. Scott Price, language arts teacher and graduation reader. Mary Brown, director of Region 5. Kay Walton, parent. Suzanne Jenkins, vice president of Jacksonville City Council and parent. And Jane Condon, principal, LaVilla Middle School of the Arts. Thank you, Heather Stevens. We are here today to honor the 2002 graduating class of Douglas Sanderson School of the Arts. This class is formed by a group of very talented, determined, passionate individuals who ventured to this school pursuing dreams of studying music, dance, theater, creative writing, film and television production, and visual art. Now, 4 years later, these graduates have studied and trained with some of the best teachers in their fields. They have received an in-depth exposure to the fine arts and now are ready to take another step toward fulfilling their dreams of mastering their art. Ernest Boyer, in a report on art and secondary education, exclaimed the importance of arts in education. From the dawn of civilization, men and women have used arts to transmit the heritage of a people and express human joys and sorrows. They are the means by which a civilization can be measured. It is no accident that dictators who seek to control the minds and hearts of men suppress not just the written and spoken word, but music, dance, and all the arts as well. It is no accident that when a civilization is dead, often the only proof of its existence is left in art. The arts are an essential part of the human experience. They are not a frill. We recommend that all students study the arts. We conclude that the arts not only give expression to the profound urgings of the human spirit, they also validate our feelings in a world that deadens feelings. More than ever before, all people need to see clearly, hear acutely, and feel sensitively through the arts. These skills are no longer just desirable. They are essential if we are to survive together with civility and joy. At Douglas Anderson, it isn't always easy to find the balance. That is all that is necessary to maintain the excellence in academic areas of study as well as excellence in the arts. Discipline, time, effort, energy, and overall commitment have become the theme of these students who have grown and matured and been a part of a school that encouraged them to develop and explore and refine their talents as well as learn an appreciation for all the arts. Clearly it is that they have learned the beginnings of something new and wonderful together. The graduating class of 2002 has reason indeed to be proud. 91% of this class will be pursuing post-secondary studies. 57% will be attending four-year universities, 14% art conservatories, and 21% community colleges. 2% will be joining the military, while 6% will be joining the workforce. Douglas Anderson graduates will be attending one of 42 colleges and universities throughout the United States. Many of these colleges and universities are our nation's most prestigious art schools. 61% of the class before you has been offered grants and scholarships totaling over $3.1 million. And I want you to know that the money was awarded because of merit and achievement in academics as well as talent in the arts. I might add that that is the most money ever offered a graduating class at Douglas Anderson. It isn't every year that a school has a National Arts Merit finalist, is named by the United States Department of Education as a national leader school, is listed by the college boards as one of the best academic high schools in this country, and named by the National Foundation for the Advancement of the Arts as one of the best arts high schools in this country. Only 50 arts merit finalists are chosen nationally. Douglas Anderson has had an arts merit finalist for the last 4 years. This is a unique class for many reasons. They are bright, talented, passionate, and they hold our futures in their hands. I can say to you without reservation, the graduating class of 2002 exemplifies the motto of Douglas Anderson School of the Arts, a school where arts and academics meet in excellence. At this point in the program, I would like to recognize those who have been so much a part of the lives of these graduates for the past 4 years, and without whose expert training, they would never have come so far. It is with a great deal of pride and personal pleasure that I recognize the outstanding Douglas Anderson faculty. Faculty, would you please stand where you are? There is also here with us tonight a group without whom the seniors could never have come so far. At this point, I would like for all parents and guardians of our graduating seniors to please stand. Seniors, please stand. Parents, guardians, please. Seniors, I'd like for you to take the time to introduce School of the Arts in the 10th grade. Born in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, she is the daughter of Don and Kay Walton and the sister of two older brothers. She came to us to dance and to succeed in all her courses. She has taken a strong college preparatory program, which included honors, gifted, and advanced placement classes. Like many young, multi-talented students, Katie Walton found it difficult to focus in one area of interest. Her mother describes her as having her fingers in every pie. Katie first danced as a three-year-old and hated it. She said as a child, she did gymnastics, played the piano, participated in creative problem-solving events, acted in plays, and dreamed of being a performer, like many little girls. Then at age 10, taking her mom's advice, she took a dance class and fell in love with the art form. She discovered that dance provided her the best outlet for her creativity and for expressing those emotions that are beyond words. The true test of Katie's commitment to the study of dance occurred at the end of her ninth grade year when she decided to enroll at Douglas Anderson upon acceptance. In leaving her former school, she walked away from the number one position as the only freshman on the world-class Division Winter Guard team, which had just returned from Amsterdam, Holland, as only one of two Winter Guard teams representing the United States internationally. Katie's passion for dance, learning, leadership, and volunteer work are evident in all she does. She is quick to take a chance, start a project, or befriend a stranger. As a Youth Leadership Jacksonville participant, she co-authored a book for children living in the I.M. Sulzbacher Center for the Homeless. The book, written from a child's perspective, speaks through a character who talks to new kids about the shelter, helping them understand and better adapt to their new surroundings and school. As a dancer, Katie loves to choreograph ideas to music. She said for her, dance is about being focused, self-disciplined, and creative. She shared with me that attending an art school has provided her the unique experience of meeting and working with others of different backgrounds, experiences, and cultures. Katie, an outstanding dancer, has been a member of Douglas Anderson's Dance Theater for 2 years and has performed in over 8 Nutcracker productions. She also has performed in summer intensive dance programs by audition with the Nutmeg Conservatory in Torrington, Connecticut, and with the Boston Ballet in Massachusetts. It is obvious that the arts are an important part of Katie's life. Katie, a member of the National Honor Society, the Junior Classical League, and the Joe Berg Society, is a Youth Leadership Jacksonville board member and is this year's president of the Student Government Association and serves as her senior class parliamentarian. She was chosen this year as a super teen by Next Step magazine, one of only 8 teens in the state of Florida to be so honored. Katie was chosen by her peers for the homecoming court and has received the school's math award for Algebra 2 and the school's most prestigious Bravo award in dance. To give you an idea of this young lady's interests, she loves to visit museums and feels that whenever you experience others' art, you take a piece of them with you. Her favorite is photography because, as she explains, it captures a moment in time. Her favorite novel is Catcher in the Rye. Katie is a caring, highly motivated, respected student whose level of responsibility is most impressive indeed. She is excited about attending Southern Methodist University on a full Hunt Leadership Scholarship, which includes a year of study abroad. I have no doubts that Katie will excel. Katie has been prepared academically and has learned the skills necessary to balance an academic and artistic world so important to all of us. Southern Methodist University will receive an unusually gifted young lady. It is my pleasure and privilege to present to you, with a grade point average of 4.38, the valedictorian of the 2002 graduating class of Douglas Anderson School of the Arts, Catherine Cole Watson.
Douglas Anderson has had on my life far surpasses any school I've ever attended and goes above and beyond what a high school should be. Instead, it serves as a haven for growth of all kinds and a place where we can both explore openly and personally the depths of our soul. Never in my life have I had a support system so strong of students and teachers at Douglas Anderson. Through these people, I have learned so much about myself, my peers, life, and the distance which I can really reach. It is safe to say I will leave a wonderfully open-minded individual with a strong grasp on what I want in my life and the knowledge to get me there. I think there should be a warning given to the students the first day. Nobody leaves the way they came. It's as simple as that. Those who came here in search of change are very satisfied. And those who didn't necessarily fancy change got over it. I recall my first experience at Douglas Anderson as a transfer student my sophomore year. I don't really remember the first person I met or how I found my way around the first day, but I will never forget my first schedule change. They were leveling classes, and I was one of the lucky few chosen. I'm one of those people who didn't fancy change. So that schedule change threw everything off. Who I sat with, the people I associated with, the way I walked to class, everything. I walked into Mr. Price's A1 English class and stared at a strange room crowded with unfamiliar faces, and it was like the first day of school all over again. I thought for a second I couldn't move until Naomi Champlin recognized me and threw her arms into the air, screaming, "Hey, come over here, Katie." It was at that moment I first felt like I belonged. I sat next to Naomi on the floor, and she introduced me to her friends that were also in the class. The next class, I found out that Naomi got a schedule change, and she was transferred out. Mr. Price's class is one I will never forget, and the people I was introduced to that day are some of my closest friends, even Naomi. Through our friendships, we have discovered the most about each other. It is our friends who teach us to laugh and how to cry. They are the ones who make coming to school every day worthwhile and make graduating and leaving so hard. Perhaps it is the friendships we have forged which will be the greatest memories, because with them, Douglas Anderson extended beyond school hours and into our nights and our weekends and became a lifestyle rather than just a high school. Since it is a magnet school, students come from all over and even from other counties. Therefore, our friendships extend throughout Jacksonville and across county lines, joining together people of all backgrounds, ethnicities, and means for the love and appreciation of art. I'm one of those out-of-county students who drives an hour every day to and from with my mother, a feat which proves difficult but worthy. My mom and I have talked, argued, laughed, and shared the stories of our day. She has driven like a maniac at all hours of the day and night while I have slept for 3 years now. And I guess it is time to say thank you. Many a car rides, we ask ourselves if it has been worth it all. I think we both agree that the drive seems a small price to pay for what I have found here. I have found that the beauty of art is that it allows us to see each other, not in the way we are viewed by society, but in the way we see ourselves through our souls. And that person whom our art expresses is what our friendships are based upon and whom we grow to love. Even if I have learned nothing else, this is a lesson that I will keep dear for the rest of my journey. Just walking on campus, you cannot help but feel something. That is the spirit of Douglas Anderson. It is also this feeling which has opened our minds and our hearts to artistic and intellectual growth. Don't forget how it feels to pass Nick Holman and his mariachi band, playing for a full house of lunch students, and then to catch an interview for your cameo on Brief Delay with Chris Bryant, our weekly news show. Or perhaps stumble upon Caitlin Parrish performing a scene that both touches you and shows you another side to the kid that sat next to you in English. While at Douglas Anderson, if you haven't experienced something random and completely out of place to the point of utter confusion, all I can say is, go back. This is why we love Douglas Anderson. There has been so much support for our amazingly talented and dedicated teachers or our peers who seem to be always eager to help that we cannot help to see that we've grown by leaps and bounds artistically and intellectually. They have pushed us farther than we ever thought we could go. And when we were exhausted and ready to quit, they never took no for an answer. For that, we thank them. Maybe we weren't fully aware of it at the time, but in hindsight, they only reinforced our love for the arts and helped to build our character. I never expected to learn vital life lessons in ballet class. I guess lessons of patience, respect, confidence, and faith have no boundaries. We came to this school, students, raring to go out there and learn everything to know. And we leave, disciplined, determined, mature young artists, ready to conquer the future. It is through my arts area that I have met my two greatest friends, who I have shared many of hours with, in rehearsals, class, performance, or just waiting for rehearsal, class, and performances. While it has been a lot of work, and there have been some hard times, it is people like Lauren Newman and Jessica Clower that have helped me through all the obstacles. We find joy within each other and within our art, and always seem to make dancing fun. The times I have shared with these two have been both memorable and humorous, and I don't think I will ever meet two amazing individuals with better outlooks on life. We have shared our happiness, secrets, pains, and complaints, and have made it through. I thank them for making me have fun and not letting my compulsive tendencies take over. Well, not too much, anyway. They taught me how to see the world in different colors and shared me the lessons that I can't find in the textbooks I so meticulously study. Knowledge is valued so highly at Douglas Anderson. I have so much respect for the level of intelligence and everyone I have met, whether it be their incredible ability to articulate their thoughts or their gift of calculating difficult physics equations. Everyone has a gift. It is great to have gone to a school where both my passions for academics and art have been stressed equally. All of my teachers have been remarkable and involved in my life. I feel that they have taught me that they care more about who I was developing into than what grade I received. They taught me to see the big picture, that life isn't the trees, but rather the forest. I'm indebted to them for sharing with me the knowledge which they possess so brilliantly, and hope that one day I can find them and share a lesson or two that I have learned along the way. It is to them we owe our appreciation for preparing us for tomorrow, whatever we encounter. A great aspect of Douglas Anderson is not just our diversity, but the fact that we respect and learn about each other's diversity. I've learned that instead of judging a book by its cover, you should at least read a few chapters to see if it's any good. Our differences are what would attract each other. You can always meet someone mundane, but they can't teach you something new, something that could change your perspective on life. I think that a belief isn't truly yours until you have challenged it and still find yourself believing in that same thing. I have challenged a lot of things while I was in high school, and find that it has only strengthened my character and my faith. It has been a difficult senior year as far as world politics are involved. When September 11 hit, it did not exclude us in the least. We sat in our classes watching, just as the rest of America did, in complete astonishment at the havoc wreaked upon our country. As teenagers on the verge of adulthood, I think all of us have felt the impact of this, at times terrifying situation. I think that our ability to keep an open mind and talk through our confusions and concerns has helped to make this year a lot easier on all of us. This is the first time for our generation to feel the fear of war. I just hope that all of us take a sense of compassion along on our journey through life, and that we see people for who they truly are inside, and not by what society eludes them to be. Tomorrow is in our hands, and if we wish for the change, then it is our job to see it through. Remember the feeling of helplessness as we sat there watching the buildings fall to the ground, the tears we shed in the aftermath, and the conversations we had about how the future can be different and how we can make that change. All this change and growth leads us to where we are today. As we sit here, we are filled with confusion for what lies ahead, a bitter sweetness towards those whom we find ourselves having to say goodbye, and that same eagerness we came to Douglas Anderson with, facing the unknown. We know that there is a whole world out there ready for us to discover, but it's within ourselves we now derive our power. So sit back and take it all in and be satisfied that this is what we've worked for and we have made it. Ralph Waldo Emerson said, "What lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny compared to what lies within us. Today is a day to celebrate that which lies within and our accomplishments, look back on the past, glimpse ahead to the future, and most importantly, thank those who have helped you to get where you are. I owe so much of my being here to my parents and my family. They showed me it was okay to dream, and then taught me how to turn that dream into reality. I thank them for never giving up on me. Though at times it may have been hard, I pushed through and I made it too. So I extend a thank you to my family, my friends, my teacher, and everyone who have contributed to making the person I have developed into. So now is the big step, the journey, so long farewell. We are all traveling down our different paths now, whether it be college, the military, a job, or just an adventure. It is now time to move ahead and let the individual whom we have been forming shine. It is at this point in our lives that we cross over into the tomorrow we've been dreaming of for years. Independence, strength, satisfaction, all things that we are questioning. Did we experience high school to the best of our ability? Are we ready to make the next move? Can we remember what it feels like to be alone in a new place? Well, it seems to be a big step. I got a hunch that we'll be calling these next few years the time of our lives. So don't fear, it will only hold you back. Instead, embrace the future. Approach life like you only get one try, because regret is the hardest thing to live with. So it is now time to start living the life we imagined. Thank you.
Mrs. Holloway, will you please come forward? Seniors, please rise. Mrs. Holloway, I am pleased to certify to you that the students assembled have completed all requirements as prescribed by the Duval County School Board in the state of Florida and are hereby entitled to receive high school degrees.
Seniors of Douglas Anderson School of the Arts, by the authority vested in the superintendent by the state of Florida and the Duval County School Board, and as the representative of the superintendent, I pronounce upon those of you who have completed the necessary requirements, graduates of the Duval County School System, and confer upon each of you all rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations, seniors.
One of the most obvious traditions at the School of the Arts is how strongly students support each other, as you've already seen. Since this evening is a special occasion for each of these young people who will be ending their high school career, in order that each of them proudly may be recognized, they have asked that I request that you hold your applause. We ask all parents and guests in the audience to join us in making sure this last experience of your artistic student is all that it traditionally has been, a ceremony of joy, beauty, and young artistic expression. Many of you over the years have expressed to me how happy you are that your daughter or son attends Douglas Anderson. You've come up and asked and stopped me in the hall and said, what can we ever do to show our appreciation? Well, tonight's the night that you can show your appreciation. The best way that you can show your appreciation is to not make a sound or yell until the very end of the presentation of diplomas. Thank you.
Fellow graduates, would you please turn your tassels from the right to the left? You may be seated. We announce with pleasure the beginning of a new tradition. This year, the National Honor Society has honored those graduating seniors who have completed at least 100 community service hours. These dedicated seniors are wearing a silver cord tonight. In this final time together, we, the class of 2002, ask you to allow us to paint the pictures in our mind of everything and everyone we wish to never forget. One being that as we walk across the stage to receive our diplomas, that we are able to hear our name loud and clear. For as you know, we have worked long and hard to be here today. Your cooperation in maintaining silence until invited to celebrate with us will make this possible. Please allow our last performance here to be a dignified and beautiful one. Now, will the Honorable Mr. Jimmy Johnson, Ms. McGlade Holloway, Ms. Kirkland, and Ms. Brinson, please take your places. The diplomas will be awarded by the Honorable Jimmy Johnson and Ms. McGlade Holloway, assisted by Ms. Kirkland and Ms. Brinson.
We are pleased to invite Mary Brown, who is the Regional 5 director, who is assisting us. Thank you.
Catherine Ray Edmire Dance.
Catherine Cole Wall Dance.
Jennifer Christine Kaufman Dance.
Felicitas Dolores Lewis Bogle.
Jessica Lynn Cherie Sneed, Theater.
Michael Andrew Figueroa.
Emmanuel DeJesus, Theater.
Melissa Ann Mueller, Dance.
Jonathan Todd Weissel.
Stephen Ray Anchorage, Theater.
Stephanie Lorraine Carney, Instrumental.
Christy Leanne Bass, Theater.
Michael Thomas Bryant, Instrumental.
Grayson Gann Ross, Theater.
Betty DeSico, Visual Arts.
Alexa. Alexis Marie Atwell Theater.
Michelle Elizabeth Hughes, Visual Arts.
Twyla Marie Rose Theater.
Colleen Ann Kimball, Instrumental.
Megan Ann Welfare Theater.
Andrew James Mason Theater.
Erin Rebecca Moss Theater.
Michelle Noelle Diskin, Dance.
Frank Joseph Alfano Jr. Theater.
Ryan Taylor Ridge Theater.
Ernest Michael Evans Theater.
Lauren Elizabeth Hill Theater.
Andrew Lee Edwards.
Michael James Reynolds, Visual Arts.
Ross Morgan Rubin Theater.
Marshall Travis Cagle, Visual Arts.
Kathy Cheyenne Manny Theater.
Christopher Michael Bryant, Film and Television Production.
Joanna Catherine Fry, Instrumental.
Lindsay Luella Wright, Creative Writing.
Dina Michelle Ginsburg, Theater.
Ashley Jewel Choate, Creative Writing.
Amanda Gail Akers, Theater.
Michael Nadir Bazzotti.
Lindsay Nicole Pruitt, Instrumental.
Dwayne Nathaniel Brown, Visual Arts.
Noelle Christina Withington, Visual Arts.
Robert Charles Quintus, Visual Arts.
Lauren Kimberly Williams, Visual Arts.
William Lamont Cribb, Visual Arts.
Margaret Valerie Whitman, Visual Arts.
Ebony Iman Bell, Dance.
Megan Kathleen Woodworth, Visual Arts.
Amy Elizabeth Thompson, Dance.
Brian Craig Schmidt, Instrumental.
Carla L. Rice, Creative Writing.
Jesse Robert Leach, Instrumental.
Fallon Dolores Johns, Instrumental.
Allison Lee Haddock, Instrumental.
Shauna Shaida Michelle Julia Teresa Peterson, Vocal.
Ricky Allen Bailey, Instrumental.
Courtney Renee Wilson, Dance.
Sarah Jane Gray, Instrumental.
Ebony Denise Booker, Theater.
Jenny Samata Davis, Instrumental.
David Charles Campbell, Instrumental.
Chelsea Rachel Franklin, Instrumental.
Naomi Vivian Chamberlain, Dance.
Rebecca Joy Thomas, Instrumental.
Natalie Rosalyn Jones, Creative Writing.
Christopher Nathan Fry, Instrumental.
Edward Joseph Spain, Creative Writing.
Michael Ross Jr., Instrumental.
Alexandra Kingsley Edwards.
Jessica Naomi Warner, Instrumental.
Jessica Nicole Sauls, Creative Writing.
Melody Lynn Neal, Instrumental.
Julie J. Heitman, Visual Arts.
Stacy Joe DiCataldo, Instrumental.
Robert William Barnwell, Theater.
Juliana Elizabeth Potter, Dance.
Justin Gary Medina, Theater.
Alicia Gwendolyn Thomas, Visual Arts.
Tara Williams, Theater.
Sarah Ashley Megan Hunter, Creative Writing.
Amanda Renee Cruz, Dance.
Casey Erin Hartman, Visual Arts.
Jessica Erin Clower, Dance.
Morgan Aris McEachin, Dance.
Lauren Perry Newman, Dance.
Jennifer Lindsay Banks, Visual Arts.
Philip John Velasco Gabriel, Visual Arts.
Elizabeth Fondino, Instrumental.
Megan Diane Kyder, Visual Arts.
Carolines Martinez, Visual Arts.
Jennifer Lacey Bagheri, Visual Arts.
Rhonda Standish Murphy, Visual Arts.
Stephen Frederick Hefner, Visual Arts.
Rebecca Ross Raconce.
Amanda Dawn Smith, Focal.
Catherine Elizabeth Hallman, Vocal.
Jamie Ann Amen, Instrumental.
Chanel Shay Holland, Visual Arts.
Christina Nicole Little, Instrumental.
Julie Marie Lynn Stubbs, Visual Arts.
Dana Lynn Johnson, Instrumental.
Courtney Janae Green, Visual Arts.
Matthew Todd Crawford, Visual Arts.
Andrew Richard Arthur, Film and Television Production.
Claudia Rose Levin.
Anne Caitlin Taylor, Dance.
Jeffrey Preston Rinfrow, Creative Writing.
Leah Krem, Dance.
Brad Russell Selvig, Theater.
Carson Jade Law, Dance.
James Peter Bildebeck, Theater.
Whitney Elizabeth Cron, Dance.
Caitlin Montanay Parrish.
Fallon Marie Collins, Creative Writing.
Daniel Owen Duncan, Theater.
Erin Elizabeth Klein, Dance.
Danessa George Popa, Theater.
Stephanie Paige Etchen, Dance.
Jennifer Ann Zozel, Theater.
Alicia Maria Luther, Dance.
Courtney Danielle Banzeski, Theater.
Nicholas Lawrence Holman, Instrumental.
Dax Andrew Dyer, Theater.
Mohammed Khalil Tarsha, Creative.
Woo! two more.
Shout at me, Joe.
All right.
We have to run it for a minute.
It's a party.
Bye.
with.
Are you coming home late 9 or so?
Good morning.
I don't know. Whatever time I wake up.
Yeah, but it's graduation. I don't
wake up at 9 in the morning.
Sure.
I came home.
There you go.
Remember my bags were packed for me?
Oh, yes. We just want to know what time to have your suitcase outside the door. Mm. Oh,
yeah. My little sack with all my clothes in it, ready for the Navy.
The end.
Yes.
Women can't resist those uniforms.
Ooh, yeah.
Volume up. You'll be married before you know it.
Shotgun wedding.
Well, are we gonna go? Or
yes,
what?
We're gonna go.
Okay, we need gas first.
We need to cross that way.
Goodbye.
Yeah, we gotta get gas.
Yeah, we did too.
We have a long ride.
Right, I always had for I-10, and just before you get going on I-10, there's a gas station right there.
There is.
Kim, are you driving?
Yeah.
Are you?
The easiest way is just pop on Bay here, take Bay all the way down. There's signs in the Bay.
We off the cliff.
Can it go that way? Kim, it's one way that way.
Okay.
Right, Mike?
Yes. Bay
Street is one way that way.
So I just make a square.
Yeah, you can see the sign.
I'll show you.
You can go just like these cars are going here.
That way.
Yep. See the sign from right
straight
here.
Straight ahead.
It says 95 beaches. See right here.
But they're going to I-10, honey, not 95 beaches.
Bye-bye. Okay. I think we can do it. I think I've got mine.
Don't get gas downtown. Get outside of town.
Okay, and we have enough time. I said goodbye.
Wait till you get to Indiana.
Girl, we have our hands off the camera. Back. Oh, you vicious. Get back.